Well, do you constantly feel zapped of energy? Lots of people do. But what if we told you you could go from exhausted to energised in just a few steps? Dr. Libby Weaver has all the answers. She's even been invited before to Sir Richard Branson's private island. Ooh. There it is, to help boost the billionaire's energy levels. Can you believe that? And lucky for us, Libby's actually in our studio now to share some of her tips. Please welcome Dr. Libby Weaver to studio.
Thank you.
Why are we all so tired all the time? What is wrong with us?
There's so much going on, and the way I like to explain it to people, because the road in can be so different for everyone, there are three pillars. It could be biochemistry, nutritional or emotional reasons. So I love to bring all of those things to life in the way I explain things, because if it's stress hormones, for example, they can take the edge off the fuel that your body uses. We use sugar or fat, so that can interfere with whether the fuel is fast burning and we're alive 1 minute and crashing the next.
Stress actually burns up energy, which robs it from you for other areas.
Yes, and it also in any given moment, the body's making a decision which fuel to use, glucose, or we could say sugar, or fat. And when we're in that hyped up, stressed, adrenaline-fueled state, then the body gets the message that it needs to use glucose, not fat, because glucose is the get out of danger, escape fast fuel, not fat. So there are enormous consequences to our energy when we lived in that hyped up state, because it's not really real.
You mentioned that there are a number of factors that can contribute to our energy or lack of. What kind of role does brain chemistry play?
It's so significant, Jess, and it's something that we need to talk about so much more. So dopamine is a neurotransmitter. It is so responsible for our motivation, for energy, for happiness, and
even
for energy.
Is that the dopamine that docks, or...?
Yes, it is. As the brain releases the dopamine, it's then got to be received. Just because it's produced doesn't mean it has an impact. It has to then be received. Mm-hmm. And there are people who have significantly altered brain chemistry. Some reasons we can name, and sometimes we don't understand why that is. The way they eat can impact it. It can be genetics. There's a whole host of environmental factors as well, like infection, that can even play a role in our brain chemistry.
Speaking of food, is it true that there are foods that can actually make you tired?
Well, such a great point to discuss, because food is supposed to energise us.
I say that turkey does that if you eat turkey.
Yeah, it's made to fall asleep.
Afterwards, it makes you sleepy. You want to have a nap?
Yes, there is. And it's in a number of protein foods, in fact.
Me.
I loved it. Just the word turkey made me laugh.
So, obviously, if you eat a whole country, it's going to make you tired.
What food, then, is it that makes you tired, and what makes you have energy?
Well, it's different for everyone, and so... The key is to pay attention. Your body doesn't have a voice, but it will give you feedback to let you know whether it's happy or not with what you're doing. And the feedback it gives you is designed to encourage you to eat, drink, move, think, breathe, believe or perceive in a new way.
So just quickly, what are a few foods that do that? So we said turkey, what are other ones?
Well,
don't eat them.
So a takeaway meal, you'll notice sometimes you get a food hangover. So people can feel really flat from that. Other people will report if they eat a lot of grains, they feel incredibly tired and just want to go to sleep after they've had a sandwich. But that's not everyone. So it's about us paying attention. Instead of just zooming through the day doing the to-do list, it's about paying attention to the feedback our body is actually giving us.
Now, you're very keen on breathing using your diaphragm muscles. Yeah. I mean, what's the point of that, and how do you do that?
Again, it's something I want everyone to know about, because when we breathe in a short, sharp, shallow way, it's adrenaline driving that. And that communicates to every cell in your body that your life's in danger, because historically that's the only time we breathed in that way. Now, when we breathe diaphragmatically, so move our belly in and out, you communicate to every cell in your body that you're safe. You burn your body fat very effectively when you breathe like that.
Really?
And when we use our body fat as a fuel, yes, our clothes fit us better.
It's hard to talk though and breathe. Yeah. Same time like that.
We can practice.
You have to breathe it right out, don't you? You have to feel your stomach going up and down.
Yes, you do.
Yeah.
Right. And it's
but when you get stressed or anxious, do you think people bypass that? All of a sudden you take those little...
You've got it. But a lot of people live like that all the time. So what...
God, I do.
That's how I breathe after I've said something the biter doesn't like.
So you should.
That's right.
But I've seen people like that. You can see people when they're nervous in a situation. And if you look closely, you can see their breathing sort of panting in a way. It's really quite interesting to observe.
You're a lady after my own heart. Yes.
Yeah. How important is sleep in all of that?
It's a big topic, and it's a big challenge for a lot of people. The number of sleeping pills that are prescribed to support people's sleep is growing and growing. And that just indicates to me that it's an area that needs a lot of attention. So we have to sleep. We can't fight our biology. Every adult needs 7 to 9 hours a night.
Good quality sleep, though.
Who's getting that?
Good quality sleep.
Good quality sleep. Yes. To do all the repair work that needs to go on inside of our body. So when it's even more reason why the breathing is of such importance
across
the day.
I've been waking up at 12:35 every night, hungry. Ooh, I make a peanut butter sandwich and I go back to bed. So at 12:35.
I'm going to do that.
We need to address your dinner.
Yeah, right. Okay.
Well, let's have a bit of a recap. We've got some tips on how you can go from exhausted to energised, very simply. Think about better food. Move daily. Better still, move every single hour. Plan for diaphragm breathing. Give priority to sleep.
So it's a big topic, and when we don't, a lot of people are prepared to stay up and do emails later into the night when really they need to go to bed. But I've put some more tips on my website, drlibby.com, and I'm touring Australia at the moment with my Why Are You So Tired tour. So love to have people join me there and learn more, because it can change a lot. Everything's more difficult when we're exhausted.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Dr. Libby Weaver, thank you very much for coming in. We'll put all of those details on our website.
Thank you.